Hi guys, alrighty, so sorry, I am making this on my iPhone. So I'm sorry, there's no makeup, hair's still wet, but I figure there's no point of putting makeup on because more than likely I probably will cry. I wanted to talk about and kind of take you guys on this journey of what I'm going through, because I feel alone. Yes, I have the kids, but I feel alone in this journey. Even though I know that, millions of people get divorced, and I know that many people are victims of domestic violence, but I feel it's almost like I have to be ashamed that I'm a victim of domestic violence. But I also don't want to be a victim of it. I want to be able to stand up and say, and I did. I was able to say, enough is enough. I am done. This is also where I have to come clean on a couple things. The biggest thing that you guys are gonna learn, and if you are a victim of it, is that you make excuses and you make lies to protect the person and to protect yourself. The biggest, well, I don't want to say the biggest lie, but what I kept from you guys was on March 3rd, no, March 7th, 2012, Mike was arrested. He threw a laundry basket at me and it hit me. But the reason I called was because it was right in front of the kids. And if it didn't hit me, it was going to hit Marguerite, who was in her crib. It's the only reason I called. I then instant after I called, I instantly felt bad. Even when the police were here, I said, "No, he didn't throw it." And they're like, "Okay." The kids are very upset. Mikey's saying that you, and I said, "No." And then the officer said, "You have to tell us the truth. What happened?" And that's when I told them. They said, "Okay, well, we have to arrest him. The state of Connecticut." They have to arrest him. And they had to arrest him even if I didn't tell them the truth, that since they got a call for domestic violence, they had to arrest him. And this is where I feel bad, and please don't judge me. If you've never been a victim of domestic violence, please don't judge. I broke the residential stay away because I wanted to work on things. I thought he could change. And really change. I figured that that was his rock bottom being arrested. So I violated. Obviously, you guys know that because I got pregnant. I got pregnant twice while we had a residential stay away. When I finally got pregnant with Madeline, there was no longer a residential stay away. He went through the classes and things were really good up until like February of 2013. And then that's when all the problems started again. We started fighting. He was very verbally abusive, calling me names, calling me fat, calling me stupid, calling me ugly, calling me lowering my self-esteem. And he did it while I was pregnant with Mikey, telling me, and yes, I did just tell you guys my daughter's name, Marguerite. I know I said I would never tell you, but you know what? I'm tired of having secrets. So. Anyways, he told me I'd be a horrible mother and that if it was a girl, I would be the worst mother in the world. I would be a horrible example of a mother, and hopefully it was a boy. And obviously, Mikey was a boy, but then I still wanted a girl. And so it was just a lot of verbal abuse. And this is another thing that I have to come clean on. My placental abrasion was because he had pushed me into the railing of our stairs pretty hard. I had a bruise. I told the doctors I fell. They didn't believe me because they said, really? Because it was a really funky angle to fall and to not have any other marks. And that's a thing. Many of you guys probably know that most people, most victims of domestic violence, are clumsy or accident prone. But keep in mind, it's not just women that are victims of it, men can be too. Just more men are reported because men are, kind of feel very ashamed of reporting it because, obviously most people go, well, you couldn't defend yourself against your wife. But, and you shouldn't have to. Nobody should ever touch you. Nobody should ever put their hands on you. It's not okay. But anyways, and then this last time, all of that verbal abuse had been building up, building up, building up, building up, and he, in front of Marguerite, said, "I'm gonna punch you in the face." And he had my phone. I couldn't call the police. I ran out of the room because I was gonna grab his phone and call the police. And because our banister, it's low, my butt. Because he came towards me and I stepped back and my butt hit the railing, and I instantly went, oh my gosh, this could turn deadly now. I need to, and I felt awful leaving the kids in the house, but I had to. I didn't want to, but I had to. So, that's kind of what happened. I'm gonna give you guys some more information later, but I will talk to you guys later. Bye.